Hi, I'm Tom Cooper with Midwestern Career College Admissions, and I'd like to welcome you to the Electroneurodiagnostic Program webinar. The mission of Midwestern Career College is to provide premier career-focused education to empower students with academic training, technical expertise, and professional support to launch or advance their successful careers. We have three campuses in Illinois, in Chicago, Naperville, and Blue Island. At Midwestern Career College, we specialize in healthcare training and education, where we have three associates of applied science and six diploma and certificate programs. The externship and clinical hours are required for most healthcare training programs, with an extensive network with many Chicago hospitals, surgery centers, and mobile monitoring companies. We have a career services department to help you prepare for your job search as well. We are nationally accredited by the Council of Occupational Education. We are approved by the Division of Private Business and Vocational Schools of the Illinois Board of Higher Education. We are a SEVIP certified school authorized to enroll non-immigrant alien students. The Electroneurodiagnostic program has 2 terms of academic and lab work in the classroom and 550 clinical hours in a hospital or medical center in Chicago. The program should take approximately 1 year to complete. It also offers a pathway to ABRIT certification as a registered EEG tech. The curriculum for this program is as follows: Intro to Neuroanatomy, Electroneurodiagnostic Technology 1 and 2, Electroneurodiagnostic Technology Lab 1 and 2, EEG Interpretation, Intro to Evoked Potential, Healthcare Laws and Ethics, and Registry Review.
Hi, my name is Mehran Jalili. I am an electroneurodiagnostic technologist. I have a registration in Evoked Potentials and EEG from ABRIT. And I have a bachelor degree in chemistry from Loyola University. In the mid-80s, my career in END started by an offer from Michael Reese Hospital to get trained on the job, and I did that, and after 2 years of working there and learning all the modalities of EEG and evoked potentials, I was led to Ingalls Hospital to start a new program for intraoperative monitoring of electroneurodiagnostic services. And I stayed there for 19 years. After so many years of working as a END technologist, I decided that I wanted to teach and train other technologists to do what I do. Originally at Ingalls Hospital, I was in charge of training many technicians, even doctors who were interested in reading EEGs. I sat with them and I helped them get acquainted with the technical aspects of EEG. And after so many years, I decided to move on and just become a teacher and use my experience to enhance other people's career. Electroneurodiagnostic studies are comprised of several different modalities, such as EEG, which is recording of the brain waves, evoked potentials, which is stimulating and recording of the brain waves, nerve conduction studies and sleep studies and long-term monitoring, and also intraoperative monitoring of END. EEG is useful for diagnosis of epilepsy, strokes, dementia, different types of central nervous system diseases, infections, movement disorders like Parkinson's, and what have you. Evoked potentials are useful for diagnosis of MS mainly and other things such as recording in during surgical intervention for orthopedic or neurosurgical procedures. For example, operating on the brainstem, taking out tumors of the brain or the brainstem or the spinal cord, taking out discs at different levels of the spine. Polysomnography is study of sleep and nerve conductions, which are usually done by neurologists, but technicians can be trained to do those, also fall under a category of END. Epilepsy is the number one reason why people would have EEGs. And people like me as technicians who perform EEGs are very helpful of diagnosis of epilepsy, because during the recording there are findings that we would have to recognize and take action upon as they are going on. Being an END technologist has been a very satisfactory career for me because I feel like I am helping so many patients and patient families throughout my career. I have performed tens of thousands of EEGs on patients with epilepsy, and we have always had the patient's best interest in our mind. In any regard, it's always a very rewarding career, and knowing that you are helping people. Another example of this would be how we interact with neurosurgeons while they're operating on the brain to correct the epilepsy. A strip of electrodes is placed on the brain and is moved around by the surgeon until the neurologist and the technician recognize the patterns underneath that are being generated. And they would take action upon our finding communicated to them.
We'd like to wrap up our presentation today with information for you on clinical requirements for our program, the Career Services Department at MCC, admission requirements, and the cost and funding options for our program. Our program offers 550 hours of clinical experience. Now, what are the benefits of a clinical experience? Well, you'll apply the knowledge and skills taught in the classroom setting in a real-world patient care environment, help you build your resume, make you become more employable, and you'll grow your professional network as well. We have a Career Services Department at MCC. Here's what you can expect from us: career planning, individual counseling, drop-in advising, professional development workshops, career prep seminars, on-campus employer interviews, and career fairs. We'll help you prepare your resume, cover letter, we'll do mock interviews with you, and we'll review social media best practices. The admission requirements are as follows. You must be 18 years of age, you must have a high school diploma or GED, you must have an admissions interview during your campus visit, you must complete the entire application process, and you must take an entrance exam, which covers math and reading comprehension. The cost is $9,450 for 3 terms, which is discounted from the normal price of $18,900. We estimate $355 for the cost of books. We accept the following forms of funding: the VA GI Bill, WIA funding for the unemployed or the underemployed, and we accept payment plans as well. If you like what you've heard today and you're interested in neurodiagnostics, give us a call at 312-236-9000, email us at admissions@mccollege.edu, or visit us online at mccollege.edu. A member of our admissions team will be on hand to work with you and answer any questions you may have. Call today because we are currently enrolling for our next start date. Thank you for your time today. We look forward to hearing from you and are ready to help you advance your education and career.